Hi, I'm Lisa Greshy, and I'm joined here on the ground at Google Cloud Next by Raj Pai of Google Cloud and Djon Kleine of BCG. Today, we will be talking about the future of AI agents and their impact across industries. Djon, what makes AI agents different today than previous waves of AI?
Well, building on a lot of the innovation that has been happening over the last couple of years, the traditional form that we've seen has been very conversational and reactive in that sense. What AI agents add is the ability to really think, plan, and act. So it can drive impact rather than just give you an answer.
And Raj, this question's for you. Where do you see the most opportunity for agents across industries?
Yeah, I think that's one of the big changes that's happened over the last several months, probably a year, is that there's opportunity across industries, because anywhere where you have knowledge and data and you want to do reasoning and thinking with it, you can see a use for agents, and that's across segments. So like in healthcare, for example, you could see agents helping summarize patient cases or make more efficient diagnoses or schedule appointments. In financial services, you could see agents helping reduce risk through analyzing investment risk opportunities and also helping customer service across retail, telco. There's lots of different places where you can see agents assisting real-world use cases.
Djon, why is process redesign so crucial when it comes to implementing AI agents?
So AI agents work best in more structured environments. And what just happens is many processes in enterprise organizations or organizations in general have been organically growing over the decades in many cases. And what is happening is if you put AI agents on top of that broken process, you're just automating inefficiencies. And when we see that happen, our clients are not really getting the value out of it. They're not getting the ROI. So taking a step back, really rethinking what is the structure of your process and how can it be different now, because agents give you a lot of new capabilities that you didn't have before, is just critical to really unlock value.
Raj, and how are the tools you're launching really helping business users, not just developers, get their work done?
No, that's a great question. If you saw like the keynote today that Thomas gave, you can see a lot of our focus is how to bring agents into the hands of everyday employees. And we talked a lot about a new product that we launched a few months ago, but that we're going very big with, which is Agent Space, right? Which is a surface, an experience, more like a SaaS-like experience, so that employees can take the power of search, the power of agents, and have that operate over all their enterprise data and be able to take actions, be able to find what they need, and be able to act on that to really enhance the way they get their jobs done every day. So I would say it's the way we want to democratize agents, and not just using agents, but we want to bring the experience of building agents to employees too. So another capability that we announced today in the keynote was a feature called Agent Designer that lets employees, knowledge workers, frontline employees, build agents that help them do the things they do every day a lot faster. And so it's a no-code experience. They don't need to know what's going on behind the scenes. They just need to set up their prompt saying, this is what I want to do, and hit a button, and it creates an agent for them that lets them automate that process again and again. So, I think a lot of what we're trying to do is take all these really high advanced reasoning capabilities and bring it to the level that how do we add value to an employee doing their job every single day?
And this question is for both of you. What kinds of organizational shifts are needed to make this transformation stick?
So there's many. To start with the low-code, no-code paradigm here, that works great to really democratize and getting the capability of building agents into the hands of everyone. When you start building more advanced process re-engineering elements, you will run into a lot of the traditional IT issues. So your data needs to be ready. There is the process redesign. There is adoption and cultural changes that need to happen. And in order to be prepared for that and be able to handle all of that as an organization, there needs to be a little bit more structure. And that goes beyond just standing up a transformation office or something else. So if you want to dive into the agent paradigm, there's new roles that you have to invent. For example, agent ops, or there's people that need to manage all of these maybe thousands of agents that you will get into your organization.
Yeah, like I totally agree with John. And I think that there's also, you have to decide how you want to structure this transformation. Like, you know, some companies, they may want a center of excellence around agents that span the entire org. Other companies have, you know, very diverse ways that they want to employ agents in their everyday line of business processes. And they may want to have each division kind of dictate their own strategy. But the more intentional you are, I think the better your outcome is going to be, because you could kind of set your goals up front and measure them as you go and make sure you're actually getting what you want out of this. Because it's not about the technology. It's about how the technology enhances your business, how it accelerates your business, how it makes you deliver more value to your end customers. And so at the end of the day, that's the goal, right? And so having a structure, having well-defined results that you want to go after, I think is super important. And that's why only part of this is a technology issue. Like, a lot of this is how you structure your org to actually take advantage of that technology to accelerate your organization and how it does its business.
John, what's holding companies back from fully deploying AI agents at scale, and how can you help?
A couple of things from our studies that we are doing around leading companies in this space. What we are seeing is that there is a question around focus. Organizations that are outperforming are much more intentional around where they spend their time and energy. So they don't do hundreds of different initiatives at the same time. They know what really drives impact, to your earlier point. So they are more focused. Second piece is they are intentional around how AI is enabling their business strategy. It's not just AI strategy. And really think that through end to end. They have a structure in place, where right governance model in place. And they're also building the foundation, as I mentioned earlier, that to really have data and their platforms, the platforms available, to make sure that they have the right culture. They invest in cultural change. It's a big part of change management effort, because you basically introduce a new type of coworker into the organization. And doing that intentionally, very well planned, while building your foundation, that's where we see most success. So it's honestly, you need to re-engineer a big part of how you've been deploying technology, how you're using technology, how you're training people, which is why it's a daunting exercise to really do this at scale.
And Raj, what's really changing now that's allowing non-experts to work with agents, and how do we support that?
Yeah, I think the big thing is that the LLMs have gotten so advanced that they actually make interacting with them very simple, because now it's much more conversational. So you don't have to be an expert. If you're able to just ask a question with natural language and have an agent that's backed by one of, you know, these state-of-the-art models like Gemini, be able to come up with a very human-like response, you're basically taking this capability and these really advanced reasoning abilities that these agents have, and you're bringing that to just about anyone who could ask a question, right? And so that's the real advancement, I think, has come that our models have evolved so much that they are very human-like, which means that any human can interact with them. And the agents are, they've almost got an understanding based on the way that they were trained, the way they were fine-tuned. They understand your enterprise data. They know the context that they're sitting in. So when you ask a question, they're an expert that can advise you and help you get your job done. And that makes it usable by just about anybody.
This question up next is for both of you. So what will it take for AI agents to be in the hands of every employee, not just developers?
Well, part of it is having a platform where people can use it and start experimenting with AI agents. I think the other part is making sure that you're intentional about upskilling. And we've become digital natives over the last, let's say, decade or so. So having digital capabilities, know how to use technology in your day-to-day work, has become an expectation everywhere. I think we are seeing the same shift happening right now with AI. It's just becoming a general expectation of anyone to be able to use AI, to be smart enough to know where it's going to be used, where the flaws are, how you embed it into your day-to-day work, which just requires, again, a cultural shift and a learning program. That's where we are putting a lot of focus on as BCG as well, is kind of the adoption of technology and putting it in the hands of people needs to go way beyond just deploying the tool.
Yeah, I guess to add on that, the other thing that we look at as a kind of a first principle is make it really simple. You know, like if it's very complicated to get started, you're just not going to get a lot of folks onboarding it. And second, like make sure people see the value in using your product. So that's, you know, one of the things that we're doing with our POCs in agent space is we do like a 3-month POC or a 30-day POC. And we say, look, make sure that your employees are using this and have them tell you about the before and after. Because the more value they gain, the more likely it is they're going to continue using it. And then I guess the final point is, like, we just want to make sure that companies can deploy these agentic workflows with confidence. So having this backed by kind of our security posture, our compliance that we have in Google Cloud is one of the reasons why we're able to get such traction. And it's one of the reasons why AgentSpace is the most the fastest growing enterprise software application that we've ever shipped at Google Cloud. So it's pretty amazing that all these three things together, I think the timing is also right because the LLMs have caught up to be able to support this, that we're at a real inflection point where it's just a matter of trying it out and making sure you know what you want to get out of it.
John, what's the roadmap look like for agents in the next 12 to 18 months, and how do you see them evolving?
So you should expect not just a couple of agents to be deployed. You should prepare for thousands of agents to become available from many, many different vendors, through many different platforms, from your organization, from your partners. So how do you really think about deploying these and managing these at scale? So the paradigm that I like to kind of use is agents are just a new type of coworker. So you need to figure out how you manage this new entity in combination with humans, which requires, you know, everything from making sure that you give them the right instructions, that you see what the performance is, that you adjust, you coach it along the way, but also in a very diverse environment. And the pushes that also Google has been making and many others around standardization and protocols and MCP and agent to agent, is you will see an interaction of many different agents that will unlock a lot more capabilities. So, but managing that, it requires some thoughtfulness and almost setting up a new HR department for agents is the way you could think about it.
Raj, what long-term shifts do you see companies taking when it comes to integrating these agents?
Yeah, I think that long-term, companies are going to see agents as a way that they're going to accelerate their business. And the way that they're going to think about integrating it is what are their key performance measurements and how are agents actually achieving ROI? That's going to be something that every company is going to be thinking about. So it's not just about employing the technology. It's how do you change the way that you measure productivity of your employees? How do you bake this into the training that you give to employees? How do you bake this into the results that you expect, right? And I think that all of those things require like people upskilling. It requires making sure that your organizations are all aligned on a common vision. It requires, like you were saying, maybe an agent operations leader, you know, like could be in the company, could be in a business group, that's setting a vision. And because this is, everybody's job is going to change a little bit. And most people will get a lot more done. So being able to set up the right infrastructure to kind of breeze the way for that, I think is going to require a lot of intentional planning on the side of organizational leaders. And, you know, that's one of the reasons why we work very closely with partners like, you know, BCG, because they know how to walk these companies through these sort of changes. You know, this is going to be a big shift in the way that leaders think about making their employees productive. And technology is one portion that I think that, you know, we do a great job providing, but the other portion is setting the right roadmap for that sort of organizational shift.
John, what should leaders be preparing for now?
Many of the things that we are seeing is just a continuously evolving technology landscape. So how do you become nimble? How do you become agile in a way that you can adopt new technologies relatively quickly? It's really top of mind for me because you need to get strategy and technology working in lockstep going forward. So technology advances, your strategy needs to kind of work with you at the same pace. And it's not kind of a 5-year out strategy that you can set at any point in time. So prepare from a business, with a business lens. I like to say, you're not creating an AI strategy. That's a little silly. You have your business strategy, and AI needs to be an integral part of all of that. So how do you make that an embedded element of your strategy and then build the capabilities on an organizational level, rethink the processes, and build the right foundation on a technology side? You need to do that right now. There's only an expectation that it gets harder. There will be new introductions coming from great technology providers like Google every single day, every single week. And you need to be able to embed that and adopt it in order to stay ahead.
And this question is for both of you. How can these partnerships help organizations lead, not lag, in the AI agent era?
Yeah, no, I think that's a really good question, because there is this tendency right now because things are moving so fast. When I talk to customers, they're a little bit on the sidelines sometimes saying, wait, what's the next thing? What's the next thing? When do I start thinking about this? But the challenge is that if they wait too long, their competitors are going to get ahead of them, and because this is revolutionary technology. And so what I advise customers to do is find a partner that you know will give you the options, you know they'll give you the choices, that will provide you a platform, and you can bet on that platform. Models will change, we'll have new ones, state of the art will continue to advance. But if you find the right technology partner, then you know that the advances as they come will be made available to you. But then secondly, I say find the right partner to help you drive those business outcomes. And like I said before, you know, that's when partnerships with BCG that we have is an important part of our end-to-end strategy, because it's not just about technology adoption, it's about changing your business processes and leading your organization through that transformation. And that's where we found these strategic partnerships really add a lot of value, and they help set the pace and they set the goalpost for where you want to be, because you really want that up front, or else you're going to end up meandering.
Yeah, building on that, the combination between technology, process, and people completely linked to your strategy and the outcomes you want to get. I think that's magical, honestly. And that's why we are partnering very closely with Google to get the technology, the latest in our clients' organizations, but always with a business outcome focus. So we will never deploy technology for the sake of deploying technology. And that combination is very well understood, and our joint clients are really benefiting from the accelerated pace and quicker, better outcomes.
Thank you, Raj and John, for joining us. And thank you for joining us for this LinkedIn Live.